Hello everyone, and welcome back to LEGO Star Wars. Been a little bit, dealing with some other stuff over on the Twitch end of things, but we're finally here and ready to continue our trip through LEGO Star Wars, the complete saga. Now, where we left off was the end of Chapter 2 of Episode 6, so of course that means we are back on the dreaded speeder level. Which, fortunately, we did manage to get free play, or the True Jedi, after a lot of hardship. But that's okay, because now we've got lots of different abilities, such as invincibility. And we don't have to worry about the meter or anything crazy like that. So, we can just have a nice, relaxing trip through the jungle on our speeders. Now, I don't know if I can actually get back up here. I might be able to. It's gonna be a little tricky. I don't know if the game actually lets you. No, it doesn't look like it. Sequence break if we could, but I don't think that's happening. Let's see. Maybe if we stand in here. Nah, that's fine. Oh well, we'll be going back around there anyways. So, for now, we'll just kind of continue on as we did before. And see what we can get, because we have a lot of minikits. I kind of tried to abandon and just forget about the minikits, because I just really wanted to get the meter more than anything. Now, we do have a couple of new power bricks this time. We got... what did we get? We got Bounty Hunter rockets, which, unfortunately... I don't think I'll be able to show off. I think that was a new one I got. Let me just double check. Yes, Bounty Hunter rockets, which of course I can't show off this all because I was stupid and did not pick Boba Fett. But basically, Boba Fett just gets a new ability that lets him shoot rockets out of his backpack, just like in the movies. So, not too special. The rockets are pretty powerful, I would say. But probably the biggest thing you might notice here is that I did buy the ×10 stud multiplier. So, 480 times studs. As you can see, it's very, very powerful. We are already up to 2 million, and we just haven't even passed like the spawn area. So we'll be getting lots of money. Money is no longer an issue. Of course, we still have the 8 times stud multiplier to collect, which I think is on this level because there is a power brick here somewhere that we did not collect earlier. So this level proceeds pretty much like normal. Even in free play, there isn't really a lot of bonus stuff. I think near the end there might be a couple little things that we'll be doing our bonus, but for the most part, it's just going to be the speeder stuff here. Now, we do have the minikit and power brick detector. The problem is that most of this level's actually... can I get on here, please? Thank you. Most of this level's actually loaded in, so because of that, it's kind of confusing to tell where all the minikits are exactly. Like, we just probably passed a whole bunch in that little screen there, and we're gonna pass another one here, but I'm gonna go back and get it because we're gonna make sure. Oh, thanks, Obi-Wan. Idiot. Never mind, we're not gonna go back and get that because Obi-Wan had to be a dick and continue on to the next part of the stage. But that's okay, because I think there's something in this area as well. Let me just double check. I think it's right. Oh, it's right here. Weird. We have to go up here. Maybe I can use this to get up here. Yeah, okay. Obviously, this is clearly free play stuff right here. Now, flashbacks to our story mode iteration of this level aside, I do like this level. It's probably one of my favorites in the game. It's definitely had its fair share of moments in previous Star Wars video games in the past. Probably one of the more well-represented movie moments. Oh, there's a minikit. Can I break out this? No, I'm going to need the AT-AT. Or AT-ST, my bad. Still getting those mixed up even after all this time, but I guess that's what I get for not playing for 2 weeks. As I try to sort out some Twitch problems. Well, not really problems, but I did get a computer upgrade, which allowed me to stream more stuff. Not even really sure what the overlap is between these videos and Twitch, although I imagine it's pretty close to 100%, all things considered, because I'm sure Not a lot of people watch these except those that come from Twitch. I know one person probably watching this right now. I'm pretty sure is quite well aware of these videos. Where's the other one? Is that here? We're getting more guys to fight. Nah, I defeated that thing already. I don't even know how much of this I'm going to leave in, because like a lot of this is just story mode stuff. There isn't really a lot of like free play things to worry about. There's like a couple of minikits in each area. There's some during... Oh, I just have to get on the vehicle, I think. My bad. A couple during the speeder sections. Of course, I can't shoot. That makes it so much better. Like, if I just had even just one of the minikits I have now, when I was doing story mode, this would be a lot better. See if I can get some more of these things. Oh, we can go back though, because we have to defeat... fortunately, our partner cannot defeat them, as usual. Partners do not do damage to enemies, so we have all the time in the world to get this one thing. Oh, thank you. They can help you with minikits, however, as you can see. I mean, this could be like a really long level or a really short level. There's another 480,000 studs, because why not? God, I love the stud multipliers in this game. Now, is this one I haven't collected? I don't know. Oh, do I have to jump it? Interesting. Okay. Excellent. Yeah, maybe I won't cut too much of this out, because, I mean, a lot of it's just me trying to actually collect them, so probably isn't a lot to cut out. Ooh. Game, please. Even with a RTX 2080 and a 10th-gen Intel, this game still likes to cause problems. Forget we're trying to run Crysis. How about trying to run LEGO Star Wars without any frame drops? Alright, where's our Bounty Hunter? Even if we don't have Boba Fett and his Bounty Hunter rockets, we still need something. Is that going to be enough to jump up here? You know what? Probably is. We have a high jumper. I said we have a high jumper. Wow, okay. I don't know if they actually did anything to... proof these levels on high jumpers. They might have. Where is he? I mean, considering you could technically unlock all the LEGO Star Wars 1 characters in Star Wars 2, it's possible that they thought about that to make it so you can't use high jumpers to cheat, because you do get the unlocks like right from the start of the game. So there is a chance that they thought about that during the level design on the original game. And where's our AT-AT-ST? I don't actually know where he is. We do need it for this. Maybe we have to defeat these guys first and then they'll show up? Possibly? I mean, we need one for the rest. Oh, is this the one we have to build it? No. Is it? Oh, maybe it is. As you can tell, it's been a little bit since I played this. Oh, I'm gonna get that. Thank you. Yeah, here it is. Never mind. I thought that was the next one we had to build it. I forgot that this one was like that, too. Is that enough? No, we need the rest of the parts, which... I don't know, they might be in here. Yeah, there they are. So all the stormtroopers just get to watch us build this AT-ST in the most excruciatingly boring way possible, as I failed to get the parts. Can you, like, shoot the cage so I can get my minikit? That'd be great. Yeah, not even super blasters will take this thing out. You have to use the AT-ST. Well, if there's ever a place for cut, now would be the time. Holy shit. Yeah, the auto-targeting on this thing kind of sucks. Sucks in the fact that it's too good. There we go, finally. Holy shit, okay. Well, that's the end of that. Oh, I need to actually open the gate. Now it's going to have a hard time targeting those two because all the speeders are getting in the way. There we go. Okay, that's two of them. Now let's see if there's any more minikits. I think we got most of the minikits in the speeder section, actually. Are you going to, like, get on the speeder or something? Yeah, I'm gonna make you walk. That's right. Get over there. Okay, let's see if there's any more minikits here. I don't think there are. Okay, where are the next ones? Here we go. This is some free play stuff. We can blow up these before. Yeah, here we go. Oh yeah, and we had this section that we can do anything with. So there's one more power brick that I don't actually know what it is. I think it's on the next stage. But basically, we've kind of maxed out. Like, we're kind of... I want to test this theory with these speeders. Yep. Oh, yeah, you totally can. Okay, that makes it way easier. So the power brick is out there. Or that's the mini kit. You know what? The power brick's probably in the final room. Now that I think about it. Whatever that arrow's pointing to has to be to the last area, because the one section of the stage that isn't loaded is the final zone up there. So whatever we're missing is that way. Okay, so there is a power brick there. Oh, and there's the minikit. Okay, good. So we did not miss anything. That arrow is just really confusing as to where things were. But yeah, I remember this now. We couldn't get either of these things, but we should be able to get both now. So this power brick's pretty easy. We just shove the gate into the hole. I'm not really sure why we need the gate on the hole, because the hole is already there. We can just crawl through the hole. But yeah, Lego Star Wars logic. There we go. There's our power brick. Probably the last new power brick that we'll get, aside from the... Oh no, this is the 8x stud. The next one will be the last new one, so... And it'll also be the last power brick, because we already got the one in 6-6. I don't remember how to actually get this thing. Do we just throw a bomb at it? Go through that door. Maybe you have to go through both doors, and that's why. Alright, we'll give that a try. Because I don't know what else to try. This has to just lead you in here. Yeah, okay, good. Then we can just go back. I was just really scared that was going to take me to the end of the stage, because that's a point of no return, and that would mean doing the entire stage again, which I really don't want to have to do. Be really nice. There we go. So there's 10 of 10 power brick. I will see you at the end of the stage, because the rest of this is literally the same thing as story mode. All right, there we go. Score times 8. And because we got 25 million studs, we have not only gone back every single stud I spent on that 10 times, we should easily be able to buy the 8x stud multiplier as well, which will give us the max multiplier that we can get in this game. So, I certainly remember the days when we had problems getting even a couple hundred thousand studs, and now millions are nothing. And we'll get an even bigger bonus because of the multiplier and our minikit completion, doubling our money essentially.